Hello everyone, this is Manjunath. Welcome back to this session. In this session, we will be learning on spreadsheet and introduction, session 1. So let's learn about features of Excel, starting Excel 2016, components of Excel 2016, creating a workbook, moving around worksheet, and types of data. So what are the features of Excel? It provides formula for performing simple and complex calculations. It helps to search data quickly, replace it instantly. Data can also be viewed in graphical form like charts. It also helps us to compute data effectively. It also provides various formatting features to improve the appearance of data. Click on Start, All Program. Scroll down the mouse button, click on Microsoft Office and click on Microsoft Excel 2010. So you can see this is the screen appears when you open Microsoft Excel. Let us discuss the components of Excel 2010. The Excel that appears on the screen is called workbook. The Excel window that appears on the screen is called workbook. By default, name assigned to the workbook is book 1, or we can call it as sheet 1, sheet 2 and sheet 3. The workbook consists of number of pages called worksheet. This is a page. So sheet 2 is also one of the page. Sheet 3 is also one of the page. So let us click on sheet 1. A worksheet is also called as spreadsheet. A worksheet consists of 148,576 rows and 16,384 columns. So if you use keyboard, control right arrow, this is the last cell of the Excel 2010, that is XFD. I'll come back to the normal position. Control left arrow. Now it is in A1 position. If you press control right arrow, it will be placed in XFD1. Now this is about the column. Number of rows, you need to press control down arrow. So you can see here 148,576 rows available in 2016. I'll come back to the beginning position. Control up arrow. So my cell is in the beginning point. Now what is cell? A cell is an intersection of rows and columns. Each cell is known by cell address, which is a combination of column letter and row number. When I click this cell, the name box appears is A1. A is a column and 1 is the row. It is a combination of rows and columns. Now active cell. So everything, whatever it is placed, is a cell, but where you click, that is an active cell. Now I'll click on A1. This is the active cell. Active cell indicates that the current cell is active. So now at present, A1 is a current cell. When you click on the cell, a thick border appears around it, which differentiates it from the rest of the cell. You can see there are so many cells here, but the cell which is clicked here, it shows the thick border, that is called active cell. Now range of cells. What is the range of cell? Now if I drag this, I have a range of cell from A1 to A10. So this is a range of cell. What is range of cell? A range is a group of continuous cells which forms the shape of a rectangle. The range can be a small as a single cell or a big as an entire worksheet. It specifies with the starting cell address followed by the ending cell address. Now next one is when I click on any place, here the name box will appear and it shows the combination of rows and columns, that is called name box. So what is name box? Name box is located on the left side of the window, as I am showing you here. It displays the location of the cell point. Now my cell point is in H9. It shows the name of the cell, or it displays the location of the cell point. Next one is formula bar. Now I'll start a small calculation, 5 and 5. Now whenever you start doing calculation, you have to start with is equal to symbol, is equal to. Now range of cell, click on this H9 plus I9. When I press enter, it will give you the sum of H9 and I9. So whatever you write using is equal to symbol is a formula. So the formula is located in the formula bar. So formula bar is located to the right side of the name box. You can see this is the name box shown in the left side, and to the right side of the name box we have formula bar. It shows the entered characters and formulas. Now by using this formula we have done some calculation. The formula is been placed in formula bar. Next one is column heading. What is column heading? Keep the cursor like this and click this. This is column heading. Column heading are the letters marked along the top border of the cell or worksheet. Each letter represents a column. Now A is a letter. It represents one column. B represent a column. C represent a column. This is how we see the column heading. Now let us see the row heading. Row heading, if I click on the number with the right arrow mark, this is row heading. Okay. So what is row heading? Row heading are the numbers marked along the left border of the worksheet. Each number represents a row. Now whenever you click this, the entire row is selected. This is called row heading. Whenever you click the column heading, entire column is been selected. That is called column heading. The next one is the ribbon. You can see there are so many options available here. These options are called as ribbon. What is ribbon now? The panel at the top of the Excel document is called ribbon. It has 7 tabs on it. Now home, insert, page layout, formulas, data, review and view. So the combination of these are called as ribbons. Each tab is divided into groups. The groups are logical collection of features designed to perform specific functions to develop or edit spreadsheets. The most used feature of groups on the ribbon. To view additional features within each group, click on the arrow at the bottom right corner of the group. Now, for example, you can see here this is one ribbon which holds font options. When you want to click the right down corner button, click this. You can see the entire option available in the format cell. I'll close this. Again, I'll go to this alignment. And again here, I'll click on this down arrow. Click this. The entire option is available here. So this is how we work with the basics of Excel 2016. Now what is status bar? So you can see here at the bottom ready. Okay, this bar is called status bar. Status bar is located at the bottom of the window. It displays information about the current selection. Now let us discuss the types of data which can be entered in an worksheet. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I can enter the numbers. Next is text data. Text data consists of alphabets, numbers, space and special characters which are not used in calculation. For example, my school name is NGIPS. So I can enter numbers and I can enter text as well. Third one is formulas data. So to do some formulas in data, you need to have some data. I'll take 10 and 10. So I have to do the calculation of both the numbers. So I'll use formula by using is equal to symbol. Is equal to 10 plus 10, enter. So the answer is 20. So I can use formulas in Excel also. So what I'm explaining is, this is entering the numbers, this is entering the text, and this is entering the formulas in the worksheet. Thank you so much for watching.